Hello. So today's video is going to be actually, it's going to be written, I guess. There are going to be a lot of links. So I'll put all the links in the description below because that'll be easier. But I still wanted to go through all through the links specifically here. And because I'm going to discuss places where you can translate for free, basically, where you can perform translations and not get paid for it. And if this seems a bit counterintuitive, I've discussed this before in other videos wherein I talk about how to get started and various different methods. And one of these methods is to provide translations pro bono for free. And I think this is a good method sometimes when you're starting out because if you, well, first of all, it gives you a track record, it gives you a portfolio, and depending on who your client is, you might be able to ask them for a reference or referral or testimonial or whatever that you can use to leverage for more translations in the future where you get paid more for. In fact, and I've mentioned this before as well, I think translating for free is better than translating for cheap. Because I mean, various reasons. Basically, when you translate for cheap, you kind of put yourself at that price level and it's almost impossible to get out of it, especially for those clients. But you know, obviously, if you're translating for free, you're not at any price level because they understand that you're volunteering your time there. You're being a volunteer, but you have your own rate, which is separate. And anyway, so if you are on websites like pros.com, Translators Cafe, everything like that, and you get your clients from there, basically, if people are offering jobs there, you can even say that you'll do it for free, which in fact brings me to, I'll use that as my first link. And I've mentioned these places before, but the main places to do websites, the main websites, sorry, the main places to do translations, the main websites where you can find translation jobs are pros.com, translatorscafe.com, and probably Upwork, which has freelance work in general. There are quite a few others. I have other videos where I go through all, you know, a whole lot of different places, a whole lot of different websites, and they can be language specific, they can be specific to your field of expertise or stuff like that. But anyway, any one of these, you can, if someone posts that they need translations done in your language combination, you can usually email them back and say, "I will do this for free." And you can just explain and be honest. You can say, "I'm just starting out. I know how to translate, but I'm really trying to get more ratings or referrals or something like that." Or you can say, I've had experience before. I just don't have experience on this website, like on pros.com or Translators Cafe. But if you give me, pros.com has what's it called? The WWA, Willingness to Work Again. So if you give me a good rating on that, then I'll translate this for free. And you can offer something like that. Say, "Oh, if you give me a good rating or referral, obviously, if you're happy with my job, then I'll translate this for free." Usually, no one says no to a free translation, right? Because they don't really have anything to lose. So this can be a good method to try to build up your expertise. If you do a couple of these, then you get, then you, once again, you get a portfolio, and you get, I mean, very often you can't use the translation, the exact translation for your portfolio, but at least you'll get a track record. And what you'll and then what you try to do at the beginning before you get accepted, you say, "I'm offering to do this pro bono for free, but in exchange, I'd really appreciate it if you're happy with my translation, you know, to leave me a good rating." And yeah, so this is probably the first place where you can do pro bono translations. These are, once again, I'll list the websites down below, the main ones at least. And then I have another, if you search for another video called, what's it called? Useful Links, I think, under my channel. And there I list a whole lot of more websites where you can find translation jobs. And you can do the same thing there usually and just offer to do it for free in exchange for a referral or a rating. So that's the first place. Where else? Sorry, I need to go and check all the links because I don't know all these links by heart. And by the way, this comes up because on my course, this was something that we'd been discussing. One of the people asked it in the discussion board. And so I replied and someone else replied and there had been discussion going on. And so, yeah, there were quite a few interesting choices there. Another place, obviously, oh yeah, is TED Talks. TED Talks offers a chance to volunteer to write their subtitles in different languages. And so I'll give a link to that as well. And that's a good place, once again, where you can develop a track record because then you can put it on your resume or on your work history. You can say that you volunteered for TED Talks, and everyone knows TED Talks. So that can always be very good. Let's see, there are some other places. So one of the people who was participating in the discussion said she volunteered for Global Voices, which is an international community of writers, bloggers, and digital activists that aims to translate and report on what is being said in citizen media worldwide. I'll leave a link to that as well. And there you can volunteer to do translation, and it can be a good place to get a track record as well. Where else do we have? So specifically, if you want to be a subtitler, there are many places you can do this. First of all, the courses, there you have online courses. As you know, I teach an online course, it's on Udemy. And Udemy is one of these places you can do it. There's another one called edX, another one called Coursera. There's also other ones called Skillshare, Skill Success, Lindy. I will leave a link to all of these down below, and so you can check all of them out. They all have different criteria, and it kind of changes. It seems like Udemy's definitely changed, at least since I started teaching there. So it's best if you just check and try to see what the criteria is for translations. But I think they all still accept volunteer translations if you want to do subtitles for them. Another place to check is Translators Without Borders. They're always looking for volunteers. That's also a good place, you know, if you specify that you did work for them. That can always look good on your resume as well. Then another place to check out is paramondo.eu. And this is another place that seems to be geared toward volunteer translators. And it seems like they kind of farm them out to different places that are in need of translations. And so that seems to be pretty good. It's almost working more on the side of the translator than not. This is all my impression. I have not used permondo.eu. By the way, I'm not affiliated with any of these websites at all. These are just ones that have either come across my radar or I've used or anything like that. But obviously I'm not associated with any of them in any way. I teach a course on Udemy, like I said, but that's got nothing to do with you volunteering to do translations or not. Anyway, those are the main ones. And what I would do if I were you is if you want to find other opportunities, you look for volunteer translation, but I will look into your other language. Like if Russian is one of your languages, then write volunteer translation in Russian on Google or whatever search engine and see what pops up there. So try it in your various different languages. And see what pops up, and you'll probably get something more language specific, more area specific. You know, if you translate into Chinese, then write it out in Chinese, write volunteer translation or any combination of those words and see what pops up, and other things should pop up. And that's a good way to find things. So, you know, once again, this is for all of you who don't have a track record yet or want to build up more of a track record and gain more experience and maybe get more ratings and referrals and testimonials. And you know, you can do volunteer translation. And this is just, I think, the quickest and best and most efficient way to find places to do this. And by the way, you get to help places like TED Talks, like Translators Without Borders, and places like this do what they do. And in fact, I know quite a few translators, by the way, who have a career translating, are getting paid, and they're still doing this pro bono because, you know, it's something they want to get done. I don't much. I did, but now I don't. I probably should actually start doing some more again. I would before just to try to, you know, keep in practice as well, because I felt that was very useful. Anyway, these are things to keep in mind, all these links. I'm also going to add another link at the bottom, which is a link to a pros.com forum where it talks about finding volunteer translation work, and that should have other links as well. I have more of a discussion of people discussing it. As other things come up, they'll probably get updated as well. So hopefully all of that can help you out for finding places to volunteer and do translations and not get paid, which, once again, might seem a bit counterintuitive, but it really can help building up your track record and building up your ratings and your referrals, because you can leverage that for more work in the future and to get paid more in the future as well. So that's it for this video. I hope you found it useful. As you can tell, I'm in my suit. I just got back from a lunch. This is neither here nor there, but since I have your attention, once again, and I know I've mentioned this before, but since you are in translation, you're dealing with international matters. If you can find international events going on in your neighborhood, in your area, then it's always worth it to attend them, I find at least. That's pretty much it. I will catch you in the next video, and I'll talk to you later. Thanks. Bye.